Hello, welcome to my channel. In previous videos, I have introduced the Excel macros on generating yearly and monthly loan schedule reports. As my screen shown, the Excel file loan generator, when I press the left hand the first macro button, loan year schedule report. Then in the top loan report, we see the generated report aggregated and yearly period. If I press the middle hand the second macro button, loan monthly schedule report. In the loan report tab, we can find a different generated report. We can find the corresponding two macros in the Visual Basic project window. For this video, in the two macros, I have added a few code lines for adding two additional report columns in report. They are accumulated principal and accumulated interest. Also, additional code lines for finding any existing chart objects in the new tab charts and clear them. Adding these codes into the two macros are quite straightforward. I shall give comments to those minor enhanced changes in my blog site. The purpose for the enhanced change is for the preparations to this video demo. If you want to know more about these minor changes, please visit my blog site, which URL links I have attached in below. In this video, I shall focus on sharing you a macro to generate 9 chart for non-schedule trend based on the generated reports. For example, in my demo Excel file, I have added one additional macro button, non-trend graph, to generate 9 chart in additional tab charts. Let's first have a demo on creating 9 chart by the macro. Press the left first macro button or run the VBA macro procedure in right-hand side VBA project window. We got a non-yearly schedule report in tab non-report. We see now any other chart existing in tab charts. Press the right end the third macro button, non-trend graph, or run the macro in the right-hand side project window. We see a non-trend report and yearly period level was generated. The code automates the process of creating a dynamic 9 chart based on loan data in the loan report tab and display the chart on the chart tab. The chart shows trends in accumulated principal, accumulated interest, and loan remaining balance over time. Once more, to press the middle second macro button, loan report for monthly schedule. In tab loan report, we see the loan monthly schedule report. This moment, in the tab charts, the previous generated graph was cleared. Let's press the right and the third macro button. In the tab charts, we see a 9 chart for monthly schedule report was generated. So the code is also flexible enough to handle both yearly and monthly loan schedule reports. Now let's go through the macro for creating 9 chart. The first part is the variable declarations. In this section, code declares several variables, such as SRC sheet and CHT sheet. Those are the worksheet variables referred to the loan report and the chart sheets, respectively. Last row, a variable to store the last row number of data in the loan report sheet. Chart OBJ, a variable of a type shape to hold the newly created chart. Chart data ranger, x-axis ranger, y-axis ranger to define rangers for the chart's data and axis. COL principal, COL interest, and COL remains balance to hold the column number for accumulated principal, accumulated interest, and non-remaining balance in the loan report sheet. COL months used for holding column number if the report type is monthly non-schedule report. Second section is to set source and chart sheets to refer to the loan report and chart sheets respectively. Third section, clear chart sheet. The code clears any existing data and charts in the charts sheet by clearing their used ranger and deleting any existing shapes chart. Fourth section, find last row of data in column A, which is date of the loan report tab using the end XLUP method. Fifth section, define the ranger for XX, which is the date. The code sets the XX ranger variable to refer to the ranger of dates excluding the headers in column A of the loan report sheet. Sixth section, find the column numbers for Y-axis data. The code uses the application.match function to find the column number for accumulated principal, accumulated interest, and non-remaining balance based on their header's name in the first row of the loan report sheet. Seventh section, define the ranger for Y-axis data series. The code sets the Y-axis ranger variable to refer to the data ranger for accumulated principal, accumulated interest, and non-remaining balance based on the previously founded column numbers. Eighth section, combine X-axis and Y-axis rangers. The code combines the X-axis ranger and Y-axis ranger to create the overall chart data ranger, which will be used as a data source for the chart. Ninth section, create the chart. The code creates a new line chart using the shapes.andChart method on the chart sheet with a specified position and size. The chart's source data is set to the chart data ranger. 10th section, adjust the chart properties. The code sets various properties for the chart, such as adding a title, axis labels, and their respective text for better visualizations. 11th, check the report type yearly or monthly. The code uses the application.match function to check if the header months exist in the first row of the loan report sheet. Based on the existence of months, the code determines whether the report is yearly or monthly. 12th section, and series names and data labels. The code adds appropriate series names and data labels for each series based on the report type, yearly or monthly. 13th section, optionally chart customization. The code sets specific line colors for the series representing accumulated principal, accumulated interest, and non-remaining balance. 14th section, display completion message. The code displays a message box informing the user that the non-scheduled trend line chart has been generated successfully, and asks them to check the chart tab to view the chart. Okay, that is all about the VBA procedure for generated line chart. The entire code is designed to automate the process of creating a dynamic line chart based on the loan data in the loan report sheet, and display the chart on the chart sheet. The code is also flexible enough to handle both yearly and monthly loan schedule reports. Let's do a test once again by running macro to create a report. Then running the macro to create a line chart. changing the loan amount, interest, and loan term. Generate report. Generate the chart. They are working perfectly. That is all about in this video. I have attached the URL link of the VBA codes in the video descriptions. Hope it brings some help for your project. Thanks for watching, and if you like to watch more videos from my channel, please press subscribe button. See you in next video.